Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. And this is lecture number 41. We are continuing with the solution on heat exchanger problem from the gate question paper. The first question in this lecture from 2007 question paper: in a counter flow heat exchanger, hot fluid enters at 65 degrees Celsius and the cold fluid leaves at 30 degrees Celsius. The mass flow rate of the hot fluid is 1 kg per second and that of the cold fluid is 2 kg per second. The specific heat of the hot fluid is 10 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and that of the cold fluid is 5 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The LMTD for that heat exchanger is, we have four options: 15 degree, 30 degree, 35 degree and 45 degree Celsius. The answer is 35 degree Celsius. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, we are given THA equal to 65 degree Celsius, TCO equal to 30 degree Celsius, MH equal to mass of the hot fluid 1 kg per second, mass of the cold fluid 2 kg per second, CPH 10 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and CPC equal to 5 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is the temperature profile of the counter flow heat exchanger. So, delta T1 is the temperature difference on the left side, delta T2 is the temperature difference on the right side. We calculate the heat capacity of the fluid, CH equal to MH CPH, which is 1 into 10 equal to 10 kilowatt per Kelvin, and CC equal to MC into CPC, which is 2 into 5 equal to 10 kilowatt per Kelvin. When CH equal to CC, the temperature profile are parallel and straight line. So, the temperature profile will be straight line and then delta T1 equal to delta T2. So, LMTD, that is equal to LMTD. So, delta T1, which is LMTD equal to 35 degree Celsius. 65 minus 30 equal to 35 degree Celsius. So, LMTD value is 35 degree Celsius. That is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2008 question paper: the LMTD of a counter flow heat exchanger is 20 degree Celsius. The cold fluid enters at 20 degree Celsius and the hot fluid enters at 100 degree Celsius. Mass flow rate of cold fluid is twice that of the hot fluid. The specific heat at constant pressure of the hot fluid is twice that of the cold fluid. The exit temperature of the cold fluid is 40 degree Celsius, 60 degree Celsius and 80 degree Celsius cannot be determined. The answer is 80 degree Celsius. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, we are given LMTD equal to 20 degree Celsius, THA equal to 100 degree Celsius, TCI equal to 20 degree Celsius, MH equal to 1 kilogram per second, MC equal to 2 times of MH and CPH equal to 2 times of CPC. So, this is the temperature profile for the counter flow heat exchanger. And we are given CH equal to MH CPH, which is MC by 2 into 2 CPC. So, MC CPC. So, heat capacity of the hot fluid is equal to heat capacity of the cold fluid. So, when CH equal to CC, when the heat capacities are equal, the temperature profile are parallel and straight line for the counter flow heat exchanger, then delta T1 equal to delta T2 is equal to LMTD. So, LMTD equal to delta T1, THI minus TCO. So, THI minus TCO on the left side. So, LMTD is 20, THI equal to 100 and TCO equal to 80 degree Celsius. That is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2009 question paper: in a parallel flow heat exchanger operating under steady state, the heat capacity rates of the hot and the cold fluids are equal. The hot fluid flowing at 1 kg per second with a specific heat 4 kJ per kilogram Kelvin enters the heat exchanger at 102 degree Celsius, while the cold fluid has an inlet temperature of 15 degree Celsius. The overall heat transfer coefficient of the heat exchanger estimated to be 1 kW per meter square Kelvin and the corresponding heat transfer surface area is 5 meter square. Neglecting the heat transfer between the heat exchanger and the ambient, the heat exchanger characterized by the following relation: 2 epsilon equal to exponential of minus 2 n to u. So, the exit temperature of the cold fluid is, we have 4 answers: 45, 55, 65, 75 degree Celsius. The correct answer is 55 degrees Celsius. So we will see how in the next slide. We are given Cc equal to Ch. Heat capacities are equal. Mh equal to 1 kilogram per second. Cph equal to 4 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Tha equal to 102 degrees Celsius. Tca equal to 15 degrees Celsius. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the area equal to 5 meter square. So heat capacity is 4000 watts per Kelvin. And we calculate NTU, which is UA by C minimum. So 1000 into 5 divided by 4000 equal to 1.25. We take the epsilon expression, epsilon equal to 1 minus e to the power minus NTU divided by 2. So epsilon equal to TCO minus TCI divided by THI minus TCI for the same value of heat capacities. Then substituting 1 minus e to the power of minus 2 into 1.25, NTU equal to 1.25 divided by 2. Equal to TCO minus 15 divided by 102 minus 15. So left hand side is 0.45895, that is equal to TCO minus 15 divided by 87. So TCO equal to 55 degree Celsius. This is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2010 question paper, an industrial gas or specific heat Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin enters a parallel flow heat exchanger at 250 degrees Celsius with a flow rate of 2 kg per second to heat water stream. The water of specific heat 4 kJ per kilogram Kelvin enters the heat exchanger at 50 degrees Celsius with a flow rate of 1 kg per second. The heat exchanger has an effectiveness of 0.75. The gas stream temperature at the exit will be, we got 4 answers, 75 degrees Celsius, 100 degrees Celsius, 125 degrees Celsius, 150 degrees Celsius. So we'll calculate. So given value Cph equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and the Thi equal to 250 degrees Celsius, Mh equal to 2 kilogram per second, Cpc equal to 4 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, Tci equal to 50 degrees Celsius, Mc equal to 1 kilogram per second and epsilon equal to 0.75. So we calculate the heat capacities. Cc equal to Mc into Cpc, which is 1 into 4000 equal to 4000 watts per Kelvin, Ch equal to Mh into Cph, which is 2 into 1000 equal to 2000 watts per meter Kelvin, and effectiveness is Ch into Thi minus Tho divided by C minimum into Thi minus Tci. So C minimum is 2000, Ch is also 2000. So substituting 0.75 equal to 2000 by 2000 into numerator, 250 minus Tho divided by 250 minus 50. So solving this equation will get Tho equal to 100 degrees Celsius. So the outlet temperature of the gas stream Tho equal to 100 degrees Celsius. The next question from 2011 question paper, cold water flowing at the 0.1 kilogram per second is heated from 20 degrees Celsius to 70 degrees Celsius in a counter flow type of heat exchanger by hot water stream flowing at 0.1 kg per second and entering at 90 degrees Celsius. The specific heat of water is 4200 joules per kilogram Kelvin and density equal to 1000 kg per meter cube. If the overall heat transfer coefficient for the heat exchanger is 2000 watts per meter square Kelvin, the required heat transfer area in meter square is, we have 4 options, 0.052, 0.525, 0.151 and 0.202. The correct answer is 0.525 meter square. So we will see how in the next slide. We show the calculation in the next slide. So the counter flow heat exchanger, MC, mass of the cold water is 0.1 kg per second. TCI equal to 20 degrees Celsius. TCO equal to 70 degrees Celsius. MH equal to 0.1 kg per second. And THI equal to 90 degrees Celsius. CPH equal to 4200 joules per kilogram Kelvin, U equal to 2000 watts per meter square Kelvin. And this is the counter flow heat exchanger. So both the fluid have the same mass and the specific heat. So CH equal to CC, that is the condition. So when CH equal to CC, the temperature profile are parallel in straight line. So delta T1 equal to delta T2 equal to LMTD, which is delta T1 THI minus TCO equal to 20 degrees Celsius. So the heat transfer area, MC Cpc into TCO minus TCI divided by U into LMTD. So 0.1 into 4200 into 50 divided by 2000 into 20 equal to 0.525 meter square. So that is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2012 question paper, water of specific heat Cp equal to 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin at 80 degrees Celsius enters a counter flow heat exchanger with a mass flow rate of 0.5 kilogram per second. Air of specific heat 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin enters at 30 degrees Celsius with a mass flow rate of 2.09 kilograms per second. If the effectiveness of the heat exchanger is 0.8, the LMTD is in degrees Celsius. We have 40, 30, 10 and 5 degrees Celsius. So, the answer is 10 degrees Celsius. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, the counter flow heat exchanger, MC equal to 0.029, mass of the cold fluid 0.029 kilogram per second, CPC equal to 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin, TCI equal to 30 degrees Celsius, MH equal to 0.5 kilogram per second, THA equal to 80 degrees Celsius, CPH equal to 4180 joules per kilogram Kelvin and epsilon equal to 0.8. We calculate the heat capacity, CC equal to MC into CPC 2.09 into 1000 equal to 2090 watts per Kelvin and CH equal to MH CPH 0.5 into 4180 equal to 2090 watts per Kelvin. And for this counter flow heat exchanger with the constant value of CC and CH, so equal value of heat capacities, epsilon equal to CH by C minimum, THI minus THO divided by THI minus TC minimum to THI minus TCI. So, substituting 0.8 equal to 2090 into 80 minus THO divided by 2090 into 80 minus 30. So, calculating the outlet temperature of the hot fluid is 40 degrees Celsius. When CC equal to CH, temperature profile are parallel in straight lines, then delta T1 equal to delta T2 LMTD. So, delta T2 equal to THO minus TCI. So, 40 minus 30 equal to 10 degree Celsius, LMTD. Next problem from 2013 question paper. Water, specific heat of 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, enters a pipe at a rate of 0.01 kilograms per second at a temperature of 20 degree Celsius. The pipe diameter is 50 mm and length equal to 3 meter. Is subject to a wall heat flux QW in watts per meter square. Question number 1. If QW equal to 2500 times of X, where X is the X is in meter and in the direction of flow, X equal to 0 at the inlet, the bulk mean temperature difference of water leaving the pipe is in degree Celsius. So, the answer is 62 degree Celsius. When QW equal to 2500 into X, the bulk mean temperature is 62 degrees Celsius. Then QW equal to 5000 watts per meter square and the convective heat transfer coefficient of the pipe outlet is 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin. The temperature in degree Celsius at the inner surface of the pipe at the outlet is, we have 71, 76, 781 and the answer is 81 degrees Celsius. So, there are two answers. So, we will see how we will show the calculation in the next slide. So, CPW equal to 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram, MW equal to 0.01 kilograms per second, TW1 equal to 20 degrees Celsius, diameter equal to 0.05 meter and length equal to 3 meter. So, the heat gained by the water equal to wall heat flux into area. So, we calculate MW, CPW, TW2 minus TW1 equal to integral QW into dA. So, QW is given, first problem, QW is given by 2500 times of X into D, area equal to pi D into X, X is the position for the entire length of the pipe, so L is the length, so pi D into X, so MW, CPW, TW2 minus TW equal to 2500 into pi D, they are constants, integrating X, so DX, it becomes DX, so X DX. So, integrating x square by 2, substituting the limit L square by 2 from 0 to 3. So, substituting the numerical values 0.01 MW 4180 into TW2 minus 20 equal to 2500 into pi into 0.05 into 9 by 2. So, calculating TW wall temperature TW2, wall temperature at the outlet TW2 equal to 62.2 degree Celsius. So, the first part of the first question, wall temperature at the outlet is 62.2 degree Celsius. Now, we take the second part, MW CPW TW2 minus TW1 equal to QW into pi DL. So, now we have to calculate the surface temperature of the pipe. So, 0.01 into 4180 into TW2 minus 200 is a 20. Now, QW equal to 5000. Now, QW is changed. For the second problem, QW is changed to 5000. 5000 into 3.14 into 0.05 into 3. Now, TW2 equal to 76.2 degree Celsius. Now, QW equal to H into TS minus TW2. So, calculating. So, 5000 equal to 1000 into TS minus 76.2. So, the surface temperature of the pipe at the outlet is 81.3 degree Celsius. The answer given in the problem is 81 degree Celsius. That is the answer. The next question from 2014 question paper. In a concentric counterflow heat exchanger, water flows through the inner tube at 25 degree Celsius and leaves at 42 degree Celsius. The engine oil enters at 100 degree Celsius and flows in the another flow passage. The exit temperature of the engine oil is 50 degree Celsius. Mass flow rate of water and the engine oil are 1.5 kg per second and 1 kg per second respectively. The specific heat of water and the oil are 4178 and 2130 joules per kilogram Kelvin respectively. The effectiveness of the heat exchanger is dash. We have to calculate the effectiveness of the heat exchanger. So, we calculate the heat capacity. So, Cc equal to Mc into Cpc, 1.5 into 4178, it is equal to 6267 watts per Kelvin. And Ch equal to Mh Cph, 1 into 2130 equal to 2130 watts per Kelvin. And we calculate the effectiveness. Ch into Thi minus Tho divided by C minimum into Thi minus Tci. So, substituting 2130 into 100 minus 50 divided by 2130 into 100 minus 25 equal to 0.667. So, the answer is 0.667. Next question from 2014 question paper. A double pipe counterflow heat exchanger transfers heat between two water streams. The tube side water at 19 liters per second is heated from 10 degree Celsius to 38 degree Celsius. The shell side water at 25 liters per second is entering at 46 degree Celsius. Assume constant properties of water, density equal to 1000 kg per meter cube and specific heat equal to 4186 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The LMTD is dash degree Celsius. You have to calculate the LMTD. So, this is 11.02 degree Celsius. So, we will see how in the next slide, we will show the calculation next slide.
So, the given data, MC, mass of the cooling fluid, 19 LPS, it is water. So, density is 1000, 19 LPS equal to 19 kilogram per second, TCI equal to 10 degree Celsius, TCO equal to 38 degree Celsius, MH equal to 25 LPS, which is 25 kilogram per second, THI equal to 46 degree Celsius. The specific heats are constant, 4186 joules per kilogram Kelvin for both water, hot and the cold water. So, heat gained by the cold fluid is equal to heat loss by the hot fluid. We take MC CPC into TCO minus TCI equal to MH CPH THI minus THO. So, substituting 19 into 4178 into 38 minus 10 equal 25 into 4178 into 46 minus THO. So, THO, temperature of the hot water at the outlet is 24.72 degree Celsius. And this is the temperature profile of the counterflow heat exchanger. So, the theta I equal to THI minus TCO, delta T1, theta I inlet. So, 46 minus 38 equal to 8 degree Celsius. Theta O, THO minus TCI, which is 24.72 minus 10 equal to 14.72. So, LMTD is theta I minus theta O divided by logarithmic of theta I by theta O. So, substituting 8 minus 14.72 divided by logarithmic of 8 by 14.72 equal to 11.02 degree Celsius. That is the LMTD value. The next question from 2015 question paper, a balanced counter flow heat exchanger has a surface area of 20 meter square and overall heat transfer coefficient 20 watts per meter square Kelvin. Air of specific heat 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin entering at 0.4 kilogram per second and 280 Kelvin is to be preheated by the air leaving the system at 0.4 kilogram per second and 300 Kelvin. The outlet temperature of the preheated air is, we have four options, 290 Kelvin, 300 Kelvin, 320 Kelvin, 350 Kelvin. The answer is 300 Kelvin. So, we will see how in the next slide. These are all the data given. Area equal to 20 meter square, overall heat transfer coefficient 20 watts per meter square Kelvin, Cp equal to 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin, Mc equal to MH equal to 0.4 kilogram per second, the THO equal to 300 Kelvin and TCI equal to 280 Kelvin. So, here we have to calculate the outlet temperature of the preheated air, TCO. Now, heat capacities, CC equal to MCCPC 0.4 into 1000 equal to 400. CH equal to MHCPH, which is again 0.4 into 1000 equal to 400 watts per meter Kelvin. And this is the temperature profile of the counter flow heat exchanger. So, when the temperature profile are equal, CH equal to CC, the temperature profile are parallel and straight line. So, delta T1 equal to delta T2 equal to LMTD. So, THI minus TCO equal to THO minus TCI. So, the heat transfer QA LMTD, which is MCPC into TCO minus TCI. So, LMTD equal to THO minus TCI. I take the second part, UA into THO minus TCI equal to MC into TCO minus TCI. So, substituting 20 into 20 into 300 minus 280 equal to 400 into TCO minus 280, solving TCO equal to 300 Kelvin. So, the temperature of the preheated air at the outlet TCO is 300 Kelvin. The next question from 2016 question paper, consider a parallel flow heat exchanger with the area AP and the counter flow heat exchanger with the area AC. In both the heat exchanger, the hot steam flowing at 1 kilogram per second cools from 80 degree Celsius to 50 degree Celsius. For the cold steam, in both the heat exchanger, the flow rate and the inlet temperatures are 2 kg per second and 10 degree Celsius respectively. The hot and the cold steam in both the heat exchanger are the same fluid. Also, both the heat exchanger have the same overall heat transfer coefficient. The ratio of AC by AP, area of the counter flow heat exchanger divided by area of the parallel flow heat exchanger is dash. The answer is 0.928. So, the given data, MH equal to 1 kg per second, THI equal to 80 degree Celsius, THO equal to 50 degree Celsius, MC equal to 2 kg per second, and Ci equal to 10 degree Celsius. We have heat gained by the cold fluid is equal to heat lost by the hot fluid. So, MCCPC into TCO minus TCI equal to MHCPH into THI minus THO. So, we are given the condition, the both the fluid, they have the same specific heat. So, hot and the cold fluid, both have steam heat, the same fluid. So, the heat, specific heat is constant for both the fluid. So, 2 CPC, CPH, they are getting cancelled. So, 2 into TCO minus 10 equal to 1 into 80 minus 50. So, TCO equal to 25 degree Celsius. So, temperature of the cold fluid at the outlet equal to 25 degree Celsius. Then this is the parallel flow heat exchanger. For parallel flow heat exchanger, delta T1 equal to THI minus TCI, 80 minus 10 equal to 70 degree Celsius, and delta T2 equal to THO minus TCO, 50 minus 25 equal to 25 degree Celsius. We calculate the LMTD, delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by logarithmic of delta T1 by delta T2, 70 minus 25 divided by log 70 by 25 equal to 43.7 degree Celsius. Then for the counter flow heat exchanger, we calculate delta T1 equal to THI minus TCO. So, here THI minus TCO, 80 minus 25 equal to 55 degree Celsius. delta T2 THO minus TCI 50 minus 10 equal to 40 degrees Celsius. So here LMTD delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by logarithmic of delta T1 divided by delta T2, 55 minus 40 divided by logarithmic of 55 minus divided by 40 equal to 47.1 degree Celsius. Now, we have the heat transfer, equal heat transfer. So, U into A into LMTD of the parallel flow heat exchanger equal to U into A into LMTD of the counter flow heat exchanger. So, U overall heat transfer coefficient, they are equal, that is getting cancelled. So, AC by AP equal to LMTD of the parallel flow heat exchanger divided by LMTD of the counter flow heat exchanger. So, 43.1 divided by 43.7 divided by 47.1 equal to 0.928. That is the answer to the question. The next question from 2017 question paper. In a counter flow heat exchanger, water is heated at the rate of 1.5 kg per second from 40 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius by an oil entering at 120 degrees Celsius and leaving at 60 degrees Celsius. The specific heat of water and the oil are 4.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and 2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin respectively. The overall heat transfer coefficient is 400 watts per meter square Kelvin. The required heat transfer area is, we have 4 answers. The correct answer is 21.84 meter square. So, we will see how in the next slide we show the calculation. So, it is a counter flow heat exchanger, MC equal to 1.5 kg per second, TCI equal to 40 degrees Celsius, TCO equal to 80 degrees Celsius, THA equal to 120 degrees Celsius, THO equal to 60 degrees Celsius, CPC equal to 4.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, CPH equal to 2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and U equal to 400 watts per meter square Kelvin. So, this is the temperature profile of the counter flow heat exchanger. So, we have delta T1 equal to 40 degrees Celsius, delta T2 equal to 20 degrees Celsius and we calculate the LMTD. So, delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by logarithmic of delta T1 divided by delta T2. So, calculating 40 minus 20 divided by 40 by 20 equal to 28.854 degrees Celsius and the area of the heat exchanger. So, A equal to heat transfer Q equal to UA LMTD, so area equal to heat transfer MC CPC TCO minus TCI divided by U into LMTD. So 1.5 into 4200 into 40 divided by 400 into 28.85 equal to 21.84 meter square. So the area of the heat transfer area is 21.84 meter square. This is the answer to the problem. Next problem from 2018 question paper, steam in a condenser of a thermal power plant is to be condensed at a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius and with the cooling water which enters the tubes of the condenser at 14 degrees Celsius and exit at 22 degrees Celsius. The total surface area is 50 meter square, overall heat transfer coefficient 2000 watts per meter square Kelvin. The heat transfer to the condenser is heat transfer to the condenser is dash megawatt, correct to two decimal places. The answer is 1.154 megawatt. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the temperature profile of the condenser. THA equal to THO equal to 30 degrees Celsius, TCI equal to 14 degrees Celsius, TCO equal to 22 degrees Celsius, U overall heat transfer coefficient 2000 watts per meter square Kelvin and area equal to 50 meter square. We calculate the temperature difference at the inlet, THI minus TCI equal to 30 minus 14 equal to 16 and theta O equal to THO minus TCO equal to 30 minus 22 equal to 8 degrees Celsius. So, the LMTD theta I minus theta O divided by logarithmic of theta I by theta O equal to 16 minus 8 divided by logarithmic of 16 by 8 equal to 11.54 degrees Celsius and the heat transfer equal to UA into LMTD. So, 2000 into 50 into 11.54 divided by 10 to the power 6 equal to 1.154 megawatt. That is the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You find the heat and mass transfer book which you may refer for additional information in this subject. And I upload the video of the lectures, all the subject
in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel for your better preparation to pass in the GATE examination. So thank you for watching, and please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we meet again in another video lecture on the discussion on the heat exchanger problem from the GATE question paper.